A professor at the University of Maryland asked this awesomely evil test question. You have the opportunity to earn extra points for this exam. Select whether you want 2 points or 6 points. But there is a small catch. If more than 10% of the class picks 6 points, then no one will get any points. Only I will see your selection. It will be anonymous to the rest of the class. Do you pick 2 points or 6 points? When this question was posted to Twitter, it went viral with a lot of people discussing the question. It looks like there's a dilemma here. And a lot of people thought that, look, if we at least pick 2 points, if everyone can cooperate, then at least we can get two. But that's not the game theory way to think about this question. So let's try and analyze what the correct strategic decision should be given the incentives of this question. You want to think about your choice relative to what the other people in the class are doing. And the relevant characteristic is how many people are picking six. It could be that more than 10% of the class is picking six. It could be the case that fewer than 10% of the class is picking six. Or there's a small probability that maybe exactly 10% of the other people are picking six. We'll construct a matrix based on what the other people are doing to see what your payoff will be. If more than 10% of the class is picking six, then it doesn't matter whether you pick two or six. Everyone is going to get 0 points. Now, if fewer than 10% of the other people are picking six, say everyone else is picking two, then you are going to get the number of points that you pick. If you pick 2 points, you'll get two. If you pick 6 points, you'll get six. And now you can see something very interesting. You are always better off, at least as good off, picking six as if you are picking two. So picking six here is a logical choice, whether the class has more than 10% picking six or less than 10% picking six, you are always going to score more points if you pick six versus two. Now there's one third case to consider, is that maybe exactly 10% pick six. In this case, you would get two if you pick two, but you would ruin it for everyone and get zero if you pick six. You would, you know, increase the threshold beyond 10%. So in this one small scenario, you are actually better off picking 2 points. But it's kind of rare, and there's no way you could know that exactly 10% of the class is picking six. So in a class of 10, that would be exactly one person picking six and everyone else picking two. This is a very unlikely scenario. So you can kind of disregard this third possibility, and you could say picking six is a logical thing to do. But there's another reason to think about why picking six is logical. Exams are not usually based on the absolute number of points you get. It's not usually a point threshold that 90% is an A, 80% is a B. That's usually true in grade school or high school, but once you get to college, everything is usually graded on a curve. Your grade is based on how much better you do relative to everyone else. So you don't want to think about the absolute number of points you're getting. You want to think about how many more points you're getting than other people. So when you think in this relativistic method, if you get two and everyone else gets two, you're getting 0 extra points. Whereas if you get six and other people get two, then you have a chance to get 4 extra points. So we want to reduce the payouts when points are awarded by two. So if the class is getting more than 10% is picking six, no one's getting points anyway. If fewer than 10% are picking six, then when you pick two, if everyone gets two, you're not getting any more points than anyone else who's picking two. But if you get six and other people are getting two, you get 4 extra points. And then look at the third scenario where exactly 10% is picking six. So say 1 in 10 out of your 10-person class is picking 6, and one person's picking 6, everyone else is picking 2. Now, if you pick 2, then you're not going to do any better than the people who are picking 2. And if you pick 6 and spoil it for everyone, then you get 0. So when you look at the payouts now, picking 6 is always at least as good as picking 2. So in this case, picking six is the logical choice, and it's what's known as a weakly dominant strategy. So when you have a weakly dominant strategy, you're going to want to play it. Now, the unfortunate outcome, even though everyone individually is thinking about picking six and they all pick six, you end up in a situation that everyone ends up with 0 points. But this is not because any individual person is thinking wrong. This game is sort of rigged so that the group outcome sort of says, oh, you pick six, you're selfish. But that's not really the case. I think it should be your decision to pick six, and that's the logical thing to do. Thanks for watching this video. If you like more videos about game theory and math, please subscribe to my channel. You can catch me on my blog, Mind Your Decisions, which you can follow on Facebook, Google+, and Patreon. You can also catch me on social media, at Presh Talwalkar. And if you like this video, please check out my books. I've written a book about game theory, An Introduction to Strategic Thinking, which will help you understand this example and many more ways to use math to outsmart your opponents.